See what I've got here. Yet another Silicon Graphics Indigo 2 workstation.
Wait a second, we've been seeing this one already 1 year ago.
Nah, you've been seeing an Indigo 2, but not this one here, as the other one sits right here. I didn't intend to get this one, but hey, it's an SGI, and one does not simply let go of an SGI if it's laid into your hands. Said that, while doing the first inspection of this machine, I found it still boots into SGI IRIX. Now, if only I had the root password. Obsolete computer technology is my passion. I'm the vintage collector, and these are my stories. Okay, so before I head into resetting the root password, you may be interested to learn about the overall condition of this machine. And what is this machine anyway? In short, Silicon Graphics was a manufacturer of graphics design Unix workstations and was not only prominently featured in Jurassic Park, but actually all the 3D animations for the dinosaurs were also rendered on SGI gear. If you're interested, you'll find plenty of SGI related videos on this channel. Aside, if you never heard about SGI anyway, maybe you want to also check out LGR, who did a full-length episode specifically about the Indigo 2, and I can really recommend go watching it. Meanwhile, I've bulked that heavyweight onto my workbench. If you're into buying an SGI Indigo 2, you may want to check for this small detail here. This rail is the safety lock for theft protection. Of course, today that doesn't make sense anymore, but keep in mind, back in the days, these workstations easily cost well into the region of $100,000. So for a complete system, you definitely want the anti-theft rail. The front bezel can be removed by simply pushing those two clips upwards. Besides the dust, the bezel is intact, if we exclude the fact that the case in general has some wear. To open the case, there's two additional push buttons down here, which will allow you to lift up the cover. Be gentle, as these plastic cases become a bit brittle and are prone to breakages. You see that here, as there's one piece of the bottom shell already missing. I will need to see how to fix that. Aside from lots of dust, the machine looks quite okay on the inside. Even the hard drive is still installed. As always, I plugged the machine to my special power strip, which has its own circuit breaker. This prevents the entire basement going dark should the machine have some electrical issue and blow a fuse. But it looks good. I hear the typical Indigo 2 startup chime. I'll hit the escape key right away to enter the PROM monitor, from where I can also fire the HINV command, which gives me some idea on the system specs already. It has a 175 MHz R10K MIPS CPU, which is the second fastest CPU ever made for this machine, only surpassed by the 195 MHz R10K. As for the graphics card, the Solid Impact is the lowest spec base option. Check my earlier video to get an idea what this means for running Quake 2. As noted before, the machine started up just fine from the hard drive, and of course, I couldn't log in as I didn't have a password. Now, does it come as a coincidence that one of my viewers just asked me days before on Discord how to reset the IRIX root password? That's actually no big deal, the easiest is to hook up a SCSI seeder on drive and boot into the software installation. This can be called up by pressing escape just after powering on the machine, then select the install option. This will ask for some appropriate SCSI IDs, and if you're uncertain, just double check with the earlier output from the HINV command. Once the IRIX installer has come up and you're at the inst prompt, you can either call up the admin menu and the shell by hitting the correct numbers, or you just use the driver command admin sh root. This will drop you into the root shell. If everything is fine with the hard drive and its file system, you can then simply run the passwd root command to set a new root password. Enter exit to end the shell, then quit to have the system reboot. Voila, now I can log in as root using the changed password. And this reveals that the machine originated from the Institute of Organic Chemistry at the University of Zurich. And the fact it runs IRIX 6.5.21, which was released in August 2003, tells us it was definitely still in service at the OCI 22 years ago. Not bad for a machine that was released in 1997. Of course, I won't be peeking around any further, as there might be still sensitive data on this machine. So I'll do what I always do when I get a machine with a working hard drive: reformatting it and applying a clean base install. Because next time, we'll have a look at this one here, an external SGI floppy drive that was sent over to me from Sweden. I'm really curious about this one. Even so, I had worked on SGI machines 25 years ago, I never had a touching point with floppy drives on those machines. It wasn't really a thing anymore by the late 90s. What do you think about it? Let me know in the comments below.
Oh, and by the way, if you're asking yourself how to support me and this channel, consider looking on my wish list for retro gear or a channel membership subscription. This would allow me to bring you even more interesting topics in the future. Thanks for watching, and see you again next Sunday.